Do you find yourself in chaos, whether it's in your mind or in circumstances? Do you give more than you receive and feel empty and deflated with nothing left to give at times? Today, I'm going to give you three ways you can protect your peace at all costs and find joy in life again. Welcome to Abide in Jesus, the podcast for women who want to experience Christ's healing touch in their lives. I'm your host, author Carolyn Rice. This podcast was inspired by day 8 of healing the father wound. The scripture for today is Proverbs 4:23 in the NIV. And it says, "Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it." This scripture is telling us to be careful of what you let into your heart and your mind. And here are three ways to guard your heart and protect your peace. Number one is think about the conversations you enter into. Recently, I had an email from someone that was really not helpful at all. It was not constructive criticism, nothing I could take away, but a personal attack based on their own hurt and pain. And I read this email and there was a part of me that wanted to defend myself. But I knew that if I did, it might only steal more of my peace. Instead, I chose to delete this email and not respond to the personal attack. Think about what conversations you want to enter into and what ones you don't. Conversations you want to protect yourself from could be someone talking about someone else, bringing up something that is triggering to you, something that leaves you with no peace of mind after you leave the conversation. Some ways that you can choose not to enter in is to walk away or just say that you're not comfortable talking about this subject. And if for some reason you have to be there, you can choose not to engage in the conversation. Which leads me to my next point, which is protect your peace by thinking about which people you allow into your life. I met with a counselor one time about a situation and person in my life that it was just wreaking havoc. They held a title of someone who should have been supportive, but instead they were being destructive, and I was having to set some firm boundaries. This counselor mentioned something I had never thought of before. They said, "The place at your table to give you advice or to speak into your life has to be earned by people. They don't just get to have it because of the title they hold. This person has not earned a place at your table. Actually, they've shown you just the opposite, that they don't deserve that place at your table." There are only certain people who have earned the right to speak into your life. It has nothing to do with the title that they hold. Who are these people in your life? And if you don't have any people like that in your life, ask the Lord to put good people in your life who will earn that right. Who has shown you that they don't have a right to be at your table or speak into your life? Have shown you that they're not for you? Is there anyone you've been allowing into your life that hasn't earned that right to be there? Do you need to set some boundaries to protect your peace? Number three is you protect your peace by guarding what you think about. What we think about has a lot to do with our peace. Sometimes, especially when we're tired, we can let the negative thoughts come and it's harder to fight them off. And this is something I'm currently working on in my own life too. Some things that I have recently put into practice are questioning the validity of the thought. Is it true? Is there evidence for that thought? Or is it just my emotions or me being fatigued? And thirdly, what does God say about this in His Word? Now, I'm certainly not perfect at this, but I'm growing, and these things have been helping me not to give in to negative thoughts that come my way. So, to protect your peace at all costs, guard your heart and mind by having boundaries around the conversations you choose to enter into or choose not to enter into. Be aware of who you let into your life and who has earned the right to speak into your life and who has not earned that right. Guard your mind from negative thoughts by questioning whether there is really evidence for that thought and comparing that thought to what Scripture says about that situation. This week, decide on one thing you will do to protect your peace. If you loved this video, hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe for more videos on finding freedom in Christ.